presented by Church Tech U. It's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to crop a picture-in-picture, either just to make it smaller or a different ratio, aspect ratio, or make it a shape in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever wanted to make a picture-in-picture in ProPresenter, and you could get it the same aspect ratio, just smaller, but you couldn't crop it, or you couldn't change the shape of it, and you want to know how, well, go ahead, like, subscribe, and tell me the story of it in the comments below. So this was actually brought up by a member of Church Tech U, my online Church Tech training community, which you can go to at churchtechu.com and join there for your entire church for one low price. So anyway, he brought it up, and at first I was thinking, well, there isn't a crop in ProPresenter, so how could I do this? And then it occurred to me. So let me show you exactly what I decided to do. So here we are in ProPresenter, and you can put the picture-in-picture on a couple of different layers. In general, I tell people probably save the props layer just in case you need to do something specific that only it can do. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to put it on the slides layer. So let's right-click, and we're going to edit the slide here. And first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to click the plus button here and go down to shape. And I need to decide what shape I want this to be. Just to make it fun, I'm going to go with a star. And I'm going to put that in the lower right-hand corner here. And I'm going to make it decent size. I could change the number of points with this slider here, you know. So, but let's stick to 5. Now here where it says fill, instead of leaving it as color, let's change that to video input. And the first thing I need to do is I need to select a video input. The one that I'm going to select is input 3, which isn't labeled, but it's the camera that's built into my computer. Next thing I need to do is not scale to fit, because what that's going to do is that's going to like try and fit the rectangle of that image within this star, and so it won't be star shaped. I'm going to go to scale to fill so that it will fill up this shape. Again, I could have done this with a circle, I could have done it with a square, a vertical rectangle, any of those shapes. I could have even drawn my own with Bezier curves, any of those things in ProPresenter. But let's do that, and I'm going to go into Inspector in a minute and I'm going to fix it, but at first I wanted to show you what it looked like. So let's go back into show mode here. Okay. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. And then let me go ahead and click on it to show it to you. Okay, you can see it live. That's actually a live video feed. Here, let me go full screen on that, and let me hide myself so you can see. That is a live video feed. This is the door to my office right here. Well, what if I wanted to reposition that so that it... Here, let me... So that you can see me. What if I wanted to reposition that so that it maybe wanted to go to the upper left-hand corner or something? Well, what I can do is I can right-click and edit that slide again. And then go to Inspector, and notice that here we have a live view of this, but if I click on this in Scale to Fill instead of putting it right here, and you are seeing a little behind the scenes, my wife would not like showing how dirty my office is, sorry about that. Let's put it in the upper right-hand corner. So top right is one of the options. And you may not have even known that these options were here, but it is right there. So now, if we, having selected that, we go back to show mode. And if I click on it, first let me hide myself, click on it again, and then we'll go, and that's better, not perfect, so I might need to reposition my camera or something like that, but you'll notice that now you can see me right here within the star, and there is latency. That's why, in general, this is a better trick for your live stream than it is for your in-person congregation, but you know, if you just need it, let's say you're doing like a Brady Bunch kind of thing, or you're doing a dating game kind of thing or something like that, then this is a fun trick to be able to do there. So that's how to crop a picture-in-picture even inside an odd shape in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7andquick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Now, some of you keep meaning to do it. Go ahead, do it now. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.